हेलो एवरीवन, आई एम बानो तकिल फ्रॉम फाइनल ईयर बी जेड सी। एज ए पार्ट ऑफ बेस्ट स्टूडेंट लेक्चरर, आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट सेल डिवीज़न। सो व्हाट इज मीन बाय सेल डिवीज़न? द डिवीज़न ऑफ सेल्स इनटू टू और थ्री और फोर, व्हाटएवर द नंबर इट मे बी, बट द डिवीज़न ऑफ सेल्स इज नोन एज सेल डिवीज़न, राइट? Where it is happening? Where does the cell division is happening? So the cell division is happening in all the living creatures. Cell division is happening in all the living creatures. So what are the living creatures? For example, humans, animals, plants, etc., etc., right? But not in non-living creatures. So the cell division is taking place in all the living creatures, right? So cell division is taking place in all the living creatures. So what is the use of cell division? So the cell division, use of cell division. So I will give you one example. At the time of your birth, what is your weight? Maybe 2 or 3 kgs, right? But now, what is your weight? 60 to 70 kgs. Some persons have 70, 80, 90 also, right? So how they gained the weight? Only because of cell division, right? Only because of cell division. So cell division taking place in our body and giving growth to our body. So that is the reason why we got this much of weight, from 2 to 3 kgs to 60 to 70, 80 kgs, right? So this is how cell division is happening in all the living creatures. So what is the reason for cell division? Reasons, what are the reasons for cell division? Why cell division has to take place? Why? So there are three reasons. First thing is growth. As I told you, to grow our body, to give growth to our body, to give growth to our body, cell division has to take place. And to repair or healing. What is mean by repair or healing? I'll give you an example. If you got an injury and your leg or hand got damaged, some flesh removed from your leg, right? But after some days, it will recover with new flesh, right? So why? How it is happening? How does it repair? Only because of cell division. So where the flesh is removed, at that place cell division takes place and divides into many cells and recovers the damage, right? And as in sexual reproduction also, after fertilization the zygote has to divide, right? Zygote is a single cell. So single cell is not a complete organism, right? It has to divide and form a complete organism, right? So these are the three main reasons for the cell division. So cell division is of two types. So two kinds of cell divisions are there. So first one is mitosis and the second one is meiosis. So here mitosis taking place in all the somatic cells and meiosis is taking place in sex cells or all the reproductive cells. So here you have to know that what is mean by somatic cell and what is mean by reproductive cell. The somatic cell means except reproductive cells. What are reproductive cells? Sperm cells and egg cell, right? Except reproductive cells, remaining all the cells are known as somatic cells, and which are helping to grow our body, right? So these are somatic cells. So mitosis is taking place in all the somatic cells and meiosis is taking place in all the sex cells or reproductive cells. See here, these are the sperm cells, also known as reproductive cells, and this is the egg cell. right? So this is the egg cell and these are sperm cells. Egg cell is a single cell, right? It cannot form a complete organism. It has to divide and then it has to form complete organism, right? So that is the reason why the meiosis happening in reproductive cells and the mitosis happening in somatic cells. So first, what is mean by mitosis? Mitosis produces two genetically identical cells. So mitosis means a single mother cell, a somatic single mother cell can undergo division, which means a single somatic mother cell divides into two equal identical daughter cells, right? So a single somatic mother cell undergoes and divides and forms two identical daughter cells. And mitosis referred in the following stages. So hope you understand what is mean by mitosis. Mitosis is the process division of single mother somatic cell into two daughter cells, right, with identical parts. So mitosis is taking place in four major phases. So first one is prophase and metaphase, and prophase, metaphase, anaphase and telophase. These are the four major phases which are taking place in mitosis. So the mitosis is the process of cell division. So this process is completely happening in these four stages. So let us discuss about prophase. In prophase, what is happening? So as we know, every cell has cell wall, nucleolus, nuclear membrane, cytoplasm, etc., right? So cell organelles. So at the time of prophase, early prophase stage, so the cell has nucleolus and the cell membrane, right? So at the time of early prophase, nucleolus and the cell membrane get disappeared. And in prophase, the cell begins the process of cell division, right? So the in prophase, actually in rest stage, each cell has chromatin material, which is in coiled stage and thread-like and non-identical chromatin parts. But in prophase, these coiled thread-like chromatin or genetic material condenses and thickens. And here, see, nuclear envelope disappears, right? So as I told you, the nuclear envelope means nuclear wall. Nuclear envelope is also known as nuclear wall. So nuclear wall, and every nucleus has a nucleolus, right? So the nucleolus and the nuclear wall or nuclear envelope both disappears, right? After that, centrioles migrate to opposite poles of the cell and astral spindle fibers are formed. In prophase, every animal cell has centrioles. So in prophase, the centrioles moves towards the opposite poles. In prophase, the centrioles moves towards the opposite poles and forms spindles and asters. Spindles forms towards the chromosomes, and asters forms towards the outer side, or towards the pole, right? Towards the pole, like here you can clearly see. So these are the chromosomes condensed and thickened and condensed chromosomes are visible here. and the nucleolus is not visible, which means it is disappeared, and the nuclear membrane is also disappeared. So see, after disappearing of nucleolus and nuclear membrane, so the centrioles are moving towards the opposite poles. Centrioles are moving towards the opposite poles, right? And forming spindle fibers. These are spindle fibers forming towards the chromosomes, right? Spindle fibers forming towards the chromosomes. And these are forming asters towards the poles. Asters towards the poles, right? So this is how prophase is happening. And after prophase, metaphase is taking place. So this is the major phase. This is the major phase in cell division. So I'll give you one question here. In which stage or in which phase the chromosomes are clearly observed? What is your answer? Okay. In metaphase, chromosomes are clearly observed. In many competitive exams, they asked a question. In which stage, in which phase of cell division, chromosomes are clearly observed? So what is the answer? Metaphase, right? So in metaphase, the condensed, thickened chromosomes, each chromosome has two chromatids, right? And they are clearly observed, they are clearly visible, and they are arranged on an equatorial plate, right? They are arranged on an equatorial plate of cell. So the chromosomes line up and the equator of the cell, metaphase plate, it is also known as metaphase plate, with the centrioles at the opposite ends and the spindle fibers attached to the centromeres. So every chromosome is attached with the help of centromere, right? At center. So see here, at center, every chromosome is attached with the help of centromere. Centromere, right? So the in prophase, spindle fibers are formed. So the formed spindle fibers get attached to the chromosomes in metaphase at centromere region. So the spindle fibers attached to the chromosomes at spindle fibers, right? So see here, these are microscopic studies under my these are the cells under microscope. So see, the chromosomes are condensed and clearly observed, clearly visible, and these are arranged on a equatorial plate, right? So this is how metaphase is taking place in cell division. And next, anaphase. So anaphase is the process the centromeres divide. So in anaphase, so in metaphase, spindle fibers attached to the chromosome at centromere, right? So but in here in anaphase, so spindle fibers applies opposite force towards the poles. Spindle fibers applies force opposite to the towards the poles, right? So due to this, chromosomes get divides, and centromere also divides, right? So each chromosome has two chromatids. So after division, chromatids get divided, and each chromatid is moving towards the opposite poles. One is upper opposite pole, another one is towards lower opposite pole, right? So at this point, each chromosome goes from having two sister chromatids to being two separate chromosomes, right? So here in anaphase, so the division is taking place. So division of chromosomes is taking place, division of centromere. So here the division of centromere is taking place, right? So here you can see, what is happening here under microscope? Spindle fibers contract and the chromosomes are pulled to opposite poles, right? So external force is applied. The force is applied and chromosomes are pulled towards the opposite poles, right? So here, see. So first in metaphase, the chromosomes are arranged on a equator or equatorial plate. But in anaphase, the chromosomes get divided here and moving towards the opposite poles, right? okay, and the last phase, telophase. So what happened up to anaphase? So the chromosomes are divided, right? So in telophase, what is happening in telophase? So in telophase, the nucleus actually divides. Okay, so listen here. Actually, we are talking about karyokinesis, all about karyokinesis. So we are talking about only nucleus, right? Only nucleus. Nuclear membrane is dividing. Nuclear membrane means what? Chromatin material, right? So nuclear membrane is dividing. We are talking about nucleus. So it is known as karyokinesis. Division of nucleus is known as karyokinesis. So we are talking about karyokinesis. So in telophase, nucleus actually divides, right? So in anaphase, the chromosomes are divided, right? And they move towards opposite poles. So in telophase, the divided chromosomes or chromatids moves towards the opposite poles. And again here we will see the nuclear envelope and the nucleolus reforms around the set of chromosomes at each pole. So at each pole, the nuclear membrane and nucleolus again reforms, right? So here you can see, so the divided chromatin materials move towards opposite poles, right? And again here the nucleolus and nuclear envelope reformed, right? Yes, so here you can see reformed. After this is how telophase is taking place. So after the completion of telophase, what is happening? So up till now we talked about karyokinesis, right? Now we are going to discuss about cytokinesis. Cytokinesis means the division of cytoplasm, division of cytoplasm. So after forming two nuclei in a cell, the cell has to divide into two, right? The cell has to divide into two daughter cells. So the division of cytoplasm is known as cytokinesis, right? In animal cell, a cleavage furrow form and separate daughter cells. So if you take animal cell, in animal cells, like see here, cleavage furrow, this is cleavage furrow. How it is happening? How the cytokinesis is taking place? Cleavage furrow is first, that cleavage furrow is taking place, and after this cleavage furrow is increasing eventually, and the two daughter cells are formed, right? With if you take in a plant cell, so in animal cell, cleavage furrow a cleavage furrow forms, and the cytokinesis take place, right? In plant cell, how the cytokinesis is taking place? In plant cells, a cell plate form and separates the two daughter cells. So here, see here, first a cell plate is forming. First here, in the middle of a cell, cell plates are forming. See, so how the cell plate is forming, right? In plant cells, cell plate forms and separates the two daughter cells. Here cell plate is forming. This is under microscope. See, cell plate forming. So this is separate nuclei and this is separate nuclei, right? Daughter nuclei formed in a single cell. So after formation of two nuclei, the cell plate is forming and dividing into two daughter cells. So this is how cytokinesis takes place in animal cell and plant cell. So we have some differences in animal cell and plant cell. So animal cell has centrioles and asters are present. In animal cell, centrioles and aster cells are present. In plant cell, no visible centriole or aster. There is no centriole, there is no asters in plant cells, right? And daughter cells separated by cleavage furrow. As I told you now, in animal cells, the cytokinesis is taking place throughout cleavage furrow forms and separates two daughter cells, right? plant cell, they are separated. Daughter cells are separated by the formation of cell plate. Okay, this is how the mitotic cell division is taking place. And now I am going to display. Now I am going to play a small video that covers all the cell division, not all the cell division, mitosis, about mitosis, right?
Mitosis. In this module, you will learn about mitosis. Mitosis is a process of cell division that makes possible regeneration of body parts. To elaborate, mitosis is the separation of nuclear chromosomes into two identical daughter nuclei. It is divided into four key phases: prophase, metaphase, anaphase, and telophase. An additional phase called cytokinesis occurs after the complete nuclear division. Before a dividing cell enters mitosis, it undergoes a period of growth and rest. This period is called interphase. In interphase, the genetic material of a cell increases. Prophase. During prophase, the chromatin condenses and becomes short and thick to form chromosomes. Each chromosome has two sister chromatids joined together at the centromere. The nucleolus disappears and the nuclear membrane starts to break down. The centrosomes, each with a pair of centrioles, move apart to the opposite poles, forming a spindle between them. Metaphase. During metaphase, microtubules of the spindle interact with chromosomes. This causes the chromosomes to move and align along the middle of the cell or the equatorial plate. Sister chromatids are held at the centromere, confirming the presence of protein structures called kinetochore at the surface. The kinetochore holds the chromosomes and attaches them to the spindle. Anaphase. During anaphase, the sister chromatids separate at the kinetochores and the daughter chromosomes, along with the divided centromere, move towards the opposite poles as the microtubule shortens. The poles of the spindle also move apart and help to separate the chromosomes. As the chromosomes separate completely into two sets, one at each pole, anaphase is considered complete. Telophase. During telophase, the daughter chromosomes arrive at the pole and the chromatin starts to decoil. Also, the nuclei reform along with nucleoli. This triggers the reformation of the nuclear membrane. Cytokinesis. Cytokinesis is the partition of the cytoplasm. In animals, a cleavage furrow appears in the plasma membrane, which deepens and divides the cytoplasm into two daughter cells, each containing a nucleus. In plants, new cell wall formation is triggered at the center of the cell by the formation of a cell plate. The cell plate grows outwards till it meets the existing wall, resulting in two daughter cells. In this module, you have learned, mitosis is the process of separation of nuclear chromosomes into two identical daughter nuclei. Mitosis involves four key phases: prophase, metaphase, anaphase, and telophase. In prophase, the chromatin condenses and becomes short and thick to form the chromosomes. In metaphase, microtubules of the spindle interact with the chromosomes. In anaphase, the sister chromatids separate out at the centromere and move towards the opposite poles as the microtubule becomes shorter. In telophase, daughter chromosomes arrive at the pole and chromatin starts to decoil, followed by the reformation of nucleoli and nuclei.
Have you watched the video, complete video? Yes. So that is how the exact cell division, exact mitosis is happening. Okay? Hope you understand. And and after completion of mitosis, after completion of cell division, again the cell undergoes interphase. The cell undergoes interphase, and in interphase the formed chromatin material and the genetic material again grows and develops and to attain maturity it undergoes interphase, right? It is also known as rest phase. So hope you all understand. And now I'm going to ask some questions from my lecture. So I have shown you the stages, four stages, right, which are taking place in mitosis. Okay, so here, what is this stage? Can anyone answer? What is this stage? Prophase. See here, this is prophase. So after prophase, in prophase what happens? In prophase, the chromatin material, the nuclear material get condensed and thickened, and the centrioles moves towards opposite poles and forms spindle fibers and asters, right? So this is prophase. And what is the second phase? Second phase is metaphase. So metaphase, what is happening in metaphase? So in metaphase the chromosomes are arranged on an equatorial plate, right? Chromosomes are arranged on an equatorial plate. And what is happening? The spindle fibers are attached to the chromosomes at centromere region. The spindle fibers are attached to the chromosome at spindle fibers, right? And this is what happening in metaphase. So what is the next phase? The next phase is anaphase. So in anaphase, what is happening in anaphase? In anaphase, the spindle fibers shorten and applies force opposite to each poles. So results in division of chromosomes, right? Division of chromatids. Each chromosome has two chromatids, sister chromatids. So chromosome get divides and centromere also get divide here. So the chromosomes get divided in anaphase, right? This is what happening in anaphase. So what is next phase? The next phase is telophase. So telophase, what is telophase? So the divided chromosomes moves towards the opposite poles, and here again the nucleolus and nuclear envelope reforms, and two nuclei are formed in a single cell. In telophase what happens? The disappeared nucleolus and nuclear membrane are reforms, and two nuclei formed in a single cell, right? So this is telophase. So after this is all about karyokinesis. So after that, cytokinesis has to take place. So what is mean by cytokinesis? So, and what is the next stage? Cytokinesis, right? Cytokinesis. So cytokinesis means, so the division of cell into two, two daughter cells. The division of cytoplasm, the division of cell wall, the division of cell into two daughter cells. So in animal cells, so the division is taking place, cytokinesis is taking place through cleavage furrow forms, and two daughter cells are formed in animal cells. If you take in plant cells, there is no cleavage furrow, there is a cell plate formation. In plant cells, the cell plate forms in the middle of cell, and it divides two daughter cells, right? So this is what mitosis is happening in all the living creatures, and this is about cell division. Thank you very much for giving me this golden opportunity. Thank you very much.